This is FBI breaking news.
There's a challenge coming to the Pretoria High Court on the 31st of July. And this challenge is a big one. It's called the Trial of the Plant. So Doctors for Life is launching a opposition or a challenge against the legalization of Dagga, and you're worried and concerned about the implications of legalization in South Africa. One of the questions I wanted to ask you, is it safe for teenagers to use Dagga?
I think what we need to know, well, let me just first make a statement and say that that is the most dangerous time, children and teenagers, to use Dagga. The reason being that that's a time when the brain kind of explodes in the sense that it grows extremely fast. There's approximately 100 billion cells in your brain. And they make each cell make contact with about 26,000 other cells. Now, all these connections are made, or a bulk, many of them are made during the childhood or teenage years. What happens is, if for some reason your stimulation is prevented, the stimulation of the brain, then it prunes these connections the way you would prune a tree's branches. If, on the other hand, it's stimulated, like a child that's practicing to play the violin, new connections grow, new branches grow out, and new connections are formed. Now, if you look at the areas in the brain that is all involved with the CBD receptors, that's the areas, the receptors on which THC works, or cannabis works. We've got it on the screen here. You see that calculus, calculations, logical thinking, that area in the cerebral cortex is affected. You see that the area where emotional development lies is affected. You see that the areas in the hippocampus where learning and memory lies is affected. All these temperature regulation, water balance, reproduction, all these areas are being affected by cannabis. And so we find that if a childhood or a teenager uses this, you do tremendous harm. And that's why you find that there's especially a lot of mental complications from that. They develop later in life, psychoses and things. They perform poorer at school. There's a higher prevalence of dropouts from school. A lot of them are suffering from what we call a motivational syndrome. They're simply not motivated to work hard at school. They're kind of passive and they just give up. And there's something that we learn, a word that we learn a lot about nowadays. It is called grit. That is so critical with children. Grit is the ability of a child to persevere and to try and to keep trying, even though he doesn't get the first place many times, or he comes last, he keeps trying. That is grit. And that is extremely, extremely important in the mental development of a child. And that's exactly where cannabis or Dagga hits you. It breaks the grit in a child.